Hey everyone, it's Alex, the real Mr. Robinson. Welcome to a bonus Let's Play of Star Wars Battlefront. There were some new additions to the game, and I would have done Arkham Asylum. I would have resumed Arkham Asylum now that Toho Month is done, but I'm in that mindset of if I don't deliver on some Let's Plays, even though I said I would be taking a break from Arkham Asylum while I did Toho Month, I would make up for it with a bonus video of GTA 5, but how many times can you really roam GTA 5 and just shoot things? So we're gonna take a look at the brand new Twilight on Hoth map on Walker Assault. The only bummer about like actually select, oh, that was quick. Okay, so this is a new map that's been added since last I played the game. There have been a lot of new additions since I last played the game. But when I first saw footage of this, I thought it was like a mod for the PC. I thought somebody modded this map completely, like sort of like the Battlefront 2 mods on the PC that have just been ongoing. See, that's the only bummer about not having Battlefront 2 on the PC, is that just all these additions that keep coming out that make you play the game even more than you would on a console. But what can you do? So, I have no idea where we are in this map. I could just walk in and all of a sudden, whatever team I'm on, we lose. And then, I always like using the E11. Okay, looks like we're far into... Okay, we're halfway through. I don't know if we switch to the Empire after this. Get the uplinks online. I would think we would, but this is a pretty cool map, I gotta say. Really, creative, and if I'm correct, because I'm not, like, I mean, I'm huge on Star Wars, but, whoa, not so much on the books and stuff. Oh! But if, was this map taken from, the Twilight book that was supposed to be, I forget what's it actually called, but it's supposed to be, like, a companion piece to this game, huh? Like, this game's only attempt at a story mode, Oh, that dude bit the dust. Come on, we only have one Y-Wing, and these... Oh, that's a turret! Oh, shit! Oh, crap! Not doing too well at this game. Okay. It should just say Y-Wing incoming. You're damn right about that. And there it goes. Alright, new uplinks. Yes, got it. Smart rocket. Uplinks pinpointed. Ooh. Okay, so with Battlefront, I have some... They recently announced, like, the... Ooh, Luke's here. The main DLC packs. This looks more like Renvar than it does Hoth. Like Renvar from the old Battlefront games. But anyway, this is still a cool map. But anyway, the DLC news came out of of the what's going to be in the DLC pack, which is basically Outer Rim shit. Oh! Well, at least I killed him. And I gotta say, I am very disappointed. Like, I've been one of those defenders of the game. Can I? Nope. Worth a try, though. One time, I was playing the game and I shot down a Y-Wing with just my blasters. And I was like, holy shit. Anyway, the first, like, paid DLC pack... I'm very disappointed in it, because basically, like, you go around fighting Jabba's palace, which is cool, and you get to fight, I could have saved my rocket for the AT-ST. You get to fight inside the factories of Sullust, which is pretty neat. Oh, it's underground. But what they have for, quote, heroes, unquote, is stupid. I mean, Nibnub and Greedo? No Chewbacca? No Lando Calrissian? Oh shit, the Emperor's not far behind, if there's a shock trooper right there. Ooh, snow speeder. I will take that, snow speeder.
Requesting speeder support.
This is really a cool looking map. Oh, I jammed the sensors, which I guess is good, because there's still a TIE interceptor flying around. Which is almost dead, apparently? Oh, this speeder is not very maneuverable, huh? I guess because it's meant to hug the ground more than anything, and some people got bombarded. But anyway, back to the heroes. Nibnub, and you pick Nibnub and Greedo? You already have skins of the Celestin and Rodian. Why? Plus, Greedo's dead. Greedo has no business helping the Empire out. He's just a bounty hunter. And come on, EA. You know what? I think it's best if I just stay alive and use my tow cable on the AT-AT that still has the most health, if I can survive. Alright, let's take out that TIE interceptor. It's alright. Sensors are jammed. But, yeah, they just said, we're gonna put in two, like, what I think I heard for Battlefront when they announced, like, the full idea for DLC is it would be four, two heroes for each side, and they blew it, already. So that, most likely that means... Okay, the Emperor's down. Now let's... God damn it! Okay. Oh shit. Come on. I just need to stay alive. Oh! No! Killed by herself. Yeah, we're not making this. Oh! Damn it.
The walker is exposed. Focus all firepower on it.
Yeah, we don't have this.
This is not good.
Yep, defeat. And the transport apparently blew up before the walker even shot it. Okay. Doesn't make a whole lot of sense, but whatever. But, yeah, that's just... The first DLC pack is just so disappointing. And this music definitely emphasizes my mood. Oh, excuse me. Alright, let's see what's next. I hope I get to do a run as the Empire, because I want to see the whole map. I noticed, like, the more stuff they add, like, the more, like, free DLC they put in, whether it's maps or hero skins, it always takes longer to load. Yes! Another shot at this map. So, I'm curious and worried at the same time if, like, once the final DLC pack comes around, like, when EA's officially done with this Battlefront... if it's just going to take an eternity to load, like, you have to wait 2 minutes just to load to the next thing. Yeah, I'll stay with this. Okay. Yeah, this is a pretty cool looking map. Again, it does look very much like Renvar. All right.
Deny uplink activation.
All right.
Usually there are a lot more idiots like just doing those stupid taunts, but whatever. Oh no, that's Oh, there's an AT. Someone else got it. I want that AT-ST pickup.
The rebels have taken control of the uplink station.
All right, well, let's go there. Let's stop those rebel scum. Oh, God. Never mind that. Oh, there's a trail here. I think. Yep. Note to self, look for trails and paths before you just go running up a mountain. Use your brain. I was talking to myself. So, I guess this would be a good time to, do an announcement video. There's rebels attacking me. Come on! Whoever, the guys in the AT-ST, help me out! Help me out, I'm stuck between rebel... salvage, whatever. Oh, dude's dead. Wait, is the uplink inside the down transport? Those Booyah! Oh! Well, at least I killed some dudes with a imploder. Oh, I thought that was a Zabrak. I was like, does that dude have a mohawk? Did they put in mohawks in this game? And I'm just looking at like, oh wait, no, that's a Zabrak.
The rebels have taken control of the uplink station. You must shut it down to stop a Y-wing bomber attack.
If EA puts in,
a rebel Y-wing is locked into
spiky hair or mohawks, then I'm gonna be mad. It's like, that doesn't belong in Star Wars. But anyway, announcements. So since Toho Month is done, I put up a picture of Instagram of what my schedule would be in terms of videos. I think that was the Zabrak that killed me.
We've deactivated their uplink. Prevent any reactivation attempts.
I think it was. So I put up a picture on Instagram of, like, what's next for my YouTube channel. Well, obviously, I'm going to resume Arkham Asylum after this. At the time I'm recording this, I haven't done my Zootopia review, so I actually don't know. I assume it'll be up by then, because I plan to put this up on a Tuesday. So my Zootopia review will be up. And then I'm doing reviews. I'm going to... If you saw the picture, I will be doing reviews for... the Christopher Nolan Batman movies. I did reviews of them back when The Dark Knight Rises came out on my old channel, but since we're getting a new interpretation of Batman soon in Batman v Superman, I thought it'd be cool to look back at the previous incarnation of Batman in film. Ooh, headshot.
Rebel uplink has been deactivated.
Awesome.
Proceed as planned.
Die, Nimnub! So yeah, I'll be doing the Nolan, reviewing the Nolan Batman movies. Then, in preparation for X-Men Apocalypse, I'll be reviewing all the X-Men movies I haven't reviewed. So, it's basically X-Men 1 through 3 and First Class. So, I'm looking forward to doing that. And then, in between, then for Harry Potter, I do plan to review the Harry Potter movies. Did not want to throw that. but I didn't even hit anything. Oh! That was stupid. So, like, in between the opening of The Wizarding World of Harry Potter... Ooh, I can use this. ...in Hollywood, and the release of Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them, I will be reviewing, all 8 Harry Potter movies. I originally was debating whether or not I should, just do Deathly Hallows as one whole video. Like, review both movies in one video, because they are essentially one movie, huh? It's just, there was too much material to put in one movie, huh? But I think, whoa! Almost got stepped on. I think I'll do 2 reviews for each... I think I'll do separate reviews for each part, huh? Oh shit, one walker's at half health, huh? Ooh! Oh, there are flares, that's cool. So I think I'll do that. That will be undetermined when I'll do that. Ooh. You know, I'll just... Oop. Oh, somebody took that. Somebody took that interceptor away from me. That's what I get for delaying the inevitable. But the Harry Potter reviews, it'll be a while. I need to find time to review them, like, in my schedule, because I have a bunch of other videos, like, retro reviews that I want to do, But next we'll be back, but I will definitely say that Batman will be Nolan's Batman will be before, Batman v Superman, and the X-Men movies will be before Apocalypse, so those have set dates. Harry Potter, we'll see what happens. Oh, while, I guess, at the time of recording this, I better express my thoughts on the new trailer, the first trailer for, the new Ghostbusters.
Rebels have called in a Y-Wing attack. We must deactivate their uplink
station. Oh, damn it. There are two shields? Ooh. But anyway, the trailer, I mean, for the, damn, I got massacred there. Okay, first of all, I don't think I've ever expressed my ideas on, like, a all-female Ghostbusters, and for me, I'm just like, look, if the movie's good, then that's all that really matters. I don't care if the cast is, or consists of women or not, just as long as it's good. And I do think it's kind of cool that, I don't think I've ever driven an AT-ST in a Let's Play. Whatever, we're doing it. Or maybe we have, I don't know. But it's like, I think it has a potential to be funny, and after seeing Spy that Paul Feig and Melissa McCartney did last year, I think I have, like, more faith in a female Ghostbusters movie, because I'm like, wow, that was actually a really good surprise. I'm more excited now for this Ghostbusters movie, and there's A-Wings shooting me. So, we'll see, but the trailer came out, and I'm just like, stupid. Oh, I didn't get to shoot anything. Hey, the trailer came out, and I'm just like, I don't know how to feel about this. I mean, look, it's just a trailer. I've seen terrible trailers to really good movies. I'm trying to think of some. Like, mostly when it's animated movies. I've just been like... Die, Twi'lek! I just got racist there for a second. Shit, what was I thinking about? I was shooting a Twi'lek, and then I just said I was racist because I... As the Empire, I hated Twi'leks, but what was I thinking about? Ooh.
Where are you going?
Oh, I didn't kill anyone. That same Twi'lek got revenge, I think. Or maybe that's just another player as a Twi'lek. All Twi'leks look the same to me. The trailers that I've seen, like, that are terrible to really good movies, it's mainly animated stuff, but, Spy had terrible trailers. Let's look at that right now. Spy's trailers were... The trailers for Spy were actually awful. And then I saw the movie, I was like, wow, this is actually one of the best comedies of the year. What else? What are you doing? Those rebels didn't even see me. A lot of animated movies, like mainly the Pixar movies, have had terrible trailers attached to them. I think the Lego movie and Rango are two instances where I'm like, I don't know, it doesn't look very good. Like, especially the Lego movie, just on the notion of they made a movie about Legos, but then you saw the movie and you're like, wow, that's actually much better than anyone could have thought. So that was good. So, I mean, anything could happen. It's just a trailer, and the trailer does not really tell you whether the movie's going to be good or not. I don't think we're going to make it. But right now, if I'm supposed to judge the movie based on the trailer, I don't know how to feel. Because Ghostbusters is one of my favorite comedy out there. I just think it's absolutely brilliant. It's funny. It's just so well made. Like, that's one of the defining movies of the, of the 80s.
The Jedi Skywalker near your location.
Luke's here. So, I don't know. We'll see what happens. And I do plan on reviewing the Ghostbusters movies before the new one comes out. And, I don't know. Ghostbusters, the video game? That could be a potential Let's Play in the future. I have some ideas for Let's Plays after Batman. And again, obviously, it's going to take a while before I get to... Where is he? I heard... There he is. There's Luke in his new DLC uniform that I've never shown up until now. Did I hit him? Come here, Luke! Alright. The father's here. Oh! That was bullshit. Huh? There's Vader! Those flares are beautiful. It's okay, Vader! I'm helping you out! Oh! That would have been awesome if I got him. He got so distracted by Darth Vader that I ended up killing him with a melee attack. That would have been so cool. I doubt I did, and I doubt we're winning this. Yeah, like, right after Arkham Asylum's done, I'm not going to jump straight into Arkham City or Arkham Knight, which a couple weeks ago, I beat Arkham Knight at long last, and... That game is so frustrating. Like, it's good. It's a really good game, don't get me wrong. But it's so hard. Like, it's... Okay, I mean, maybe I'm exaggerating there. Maybe it's as hard as the other games, but it really messed with me psychologically. It messed with me psychologically, and... just having, like, Scarecrow taunt you throughout the whole game. Not just when you die, but throughout when you play the game. You're just like, shut up! You are frustrating me, Scarecrow. Like, I almost lost my mind, I almost, that game almost broke me, Although, I think that was the point, so, I mean, if that's the point, like, because it's not a bad game. If the point was to, like, make me think psychologically, then they kind of did that. Oh, Luke's back. Yeah, I don't think we're doing this. So, after Batman, I don't know what Let's Play is coming next. We'll just see what happens. Whoa, there's Luke. Got me again. That was a funny animation when I was just being pushed back. What are you doing?
Now we will crush this rebellion.
The shield generator is in range, barrage ready.
And there goes one walker. If this thing survives, that's gonna be a miracle. Just a little further. A little further. Come on. Yes! Oh, that was so close. I think it had like 1 point of health left. Wow. Okay, fifth place. That's not too bad. I may have gotten too excited there. You know what? We got about 5 minutes left. What do you say we do a fighter squadron, on this map? Because I know they built it for fighter squadron, and if I'm correct, like with all the other fighter squadron maps, there are going to be a lot of clouds for no reason, really. Yep, now we're back to just regular old Hoth, So, there's an AT-ST shooting at me. I didn't get to do anything in that AT-ST. That was a bummer. Okay, moving on. Yep. I love how it just says, suggested for you, Fighter Squadron. Like, this game knows me. Knows I love flight simulators, huh? Uh-oh. The only problem... Again... What I was about to say earlier is that the whole problem of actually hand-selecting the map is that you can't be sure of how many people are in it. You know what? I'm going to make a brief cut. When it starts loading, I'll be right back. Oh! That was fast! Never mind then! Alright. It's going to jump me in. It's just like, you lose! Although, I'm starting as the Empire, so I'm imagining that this is the only chance we... This is the only time we'll be able to play it. Because I'm not going to swap over to the Rebel side after this. So it seems like every map rotation, ever since they added Jakku, it starts with the Rebels. And then it'll do the same map again, but with the Empire. That's just the impression I'm getting. For the large maps, especially. Excuse me. And I sneezed away from the mic. I'm learning. Okay, there's stuff going on. Oh, we just started. Look at that snow.
All fighters, Rebel spacecraft attacking. Destroy them before they can bring down any of our shuttles.
It'll be funny if, like, we can't see, sir. Okay, if I can find the hero pickup, that would be sweet. Ooh, okay, I'll take that. Actually, because I'm sitting. Oh, there it is.
Hostile fighter on your tail.
No! You stupid A-Wings! I was saying, one of the bummers about recording Let's Plays is, I'm sitting next to my computer and my... Oh, there's the Millennium Falcon. I'm sitting next to my computer. And I'm kind of a distance from my TV. No, I don't want to share this event. Because I didn't do much. I'm kind of a distance from my TV, so looking for the pickups, it's hard. Oh! Solo! It's a little hard to see whether there's, like, what's a hero pickup and what's not, especially in Fighter Squadron. And with all this snow, that really does not help either.
They're trying to lock onto you.
See. Oh! Kamikaze! Killed by GR-75 transport. Awesome. So is somebody Slave 1 or... Or is it just... Did I take him out? No. Wah. I don't know why I was making that noise. That's the same asshole that... Manting... 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, someone's slave one already. See right there? Well, you know what? We hit 30 minutes. I think I'll just give the rundown as we lose. So, I hope you guys... This has been a bonus video of Star Wars Battlefront, Twilight on Hoth. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Tell me what you think about it. Like, comment, subscribe, share with your friends. Don't forget to check out my official website, and you can follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, SoundCloud, and Periscope. I really want to try to get do stuff, more stuff on SoundCloud in the future. Oh, at least I killed him. And also, I'm started experimenting with Rift.TV, where I do picture-in-picture commentaries of Netflix shows, or anything that's really on Netflix, whether it's one of their original shows or movies, or whether it's already existing shows and movies. So check that out. I have a review for Courage the Cowardly Dog, one of the most bizarre shows. Ah! That, my enemy. Oh yeah, we're losing this. So check that out. And, yeah, this is the real Mr. Robinson telling you there's only one. I'm tempted to turn this off just before we hit lose, but I just want to blast a few more rebels. Is that him? No. Duff715. Yep, there we go. Well, that was fun. Even though I got some serious rage out of me. Anyway, see you guys later.